This video is going to discuss the difference between chemical and physical changes. Physical change is a reversible change in which the substance changes form but keeps its same chemical composition. So something like melting ice, it's still water, it's just now rearranged in a different form. Breaking glass, heating a light bulb filament, like you turn off the light, it goes back to being a non-glowing color. Chemical change, however, is an irreversible change where something new is formed. And you can tell this because a chemical reaction has occurred. So I have a few examples of chemical and physical changes and we'll discuss them. Breaking glass. Is it still glass or is it something new? It's still glass, so that's going to be a physical change. So we'll just put a PC there. Rusting of a bicycle. Is it still the same metal that it was or is it now something new? And if it's rusting, that's a chemical reaction, so that's a chemical change. Boiling water. Is it still water? Yeah, it's just now spread out, so that's gonna be a physical change. It's a phase change, so physical change. Spoiling food. Is it still the same substance it was? And the answer is no, now it's rotten, so that's gonna be a chemical change. Mixing lemonade powder into water. Anytime you dissolve something, all you're doing is adding it to water, and it's not reacting, so it's not a chemical change, this is a physical change. So dissolving is physical. Corroding of metal. Well, corrosion implies rusting, so it's kind of like rusting of a bicycle, and that's a reaction, so that is a chemical change. Bleaching your hair. Can you put your hair back after you bleach it? No, so that's gonna be a chemical change. Fireworks exploding. Do you get your bottle rocket back after it explodes? Nope, so that's a chemical change. Squeezing oranges to make orange juice. Well, the orange juice was in the orange, and now it's not. Still orange juice, so that's a physical change. Frying an egg. Can you unfry an egg? Nope, that's a chemical change. And melting wax. Can you make wax liquid again? Or can you make wax solid again from after you make it liquid? And the answer is yes, so that's going to be a physical change. And there's a few examples of chemical and physical changes, so I hope that clears stuff up.